Hello and welcome back to the channel. My name is David. I am a search specialist, a Squarespace specialist, all of the above. This video right now is going to be a great walkthrough. We've helped over 300 clients optimize their SEO on Squarespace. So I'm just going to walk through a few of the highlights, a few major things you should be considering if you're a DIYer, you're just doing some SEO on your own, or you just want to check in and see if you're doing it correctly. These are some great resources. Before I begin, I do want to point you to our website. I would highly recommend spending time here. We've put out a ton of content and a ton of time on the content in our guides. We also have a newsletter that we send out, and we also have this analyzer tool that I'm going to show you a little bit further in the video. And at the end of the day, if you're like, I don't want to do this at all, you could check out, we have some packages online starting at $249 and going all the way up to $574 right now at the moment, where you could come in, check out these packages, and be able to have someone do the SEO optimization for you. And so with that said, let us begin. Right before I get into this, I do want to say this. Please hit that like button. It means so much to me, a little bit to the YouTube algorithm, but it means so much to me if you find value from this video. And if you're interested, please like and subscribe and hit that notification bell. All the above help will help you if you are looking for more content just like this. Okay, so as we begin today, I am going to be covering three or four things. Right now, I'm just going to use a template to show you how to set up some of these SEO pieces, especially if you're just starting out. This will be a very useful video for you. But we're going to talk about the SEO panel. We're going to talk about on-page SEO. We're going to talk about connecting Google Search Console, two ways to do that, and also connecting Google Analytics. We're not going to go into all the details of how to do it. There's a ton of content on the website. I'm going to show you a few places where you should be focusing for SEO as you go through your site, and we might hit a few extras along the way. So first and foremost, if you're starting on a brand new site, you do want to make sure your site title is proper. So whatever your business name is. So for example, I'm just going to do our agency name, Spacebar Agency, get that set up right. It's showing you how to edit pages, all that. Cool, get started, we're good to go. The reason that's important is not just for the logo. I'm going to show you in a moment why that's important, but we're going to start there. So let's take a look. Here we have a shop, we have a journal. If I go to pages, you'll see that we have these different types of pages here. So we have a regular page here, we have an actual journal, and then we have a shop. So we're going to review kind of some of the SEO components inside of that to take a look at. But first and foremost, let's go to marketing, and then we're going to click on SEO. It's a really important page, really valuable page. First and foremost, what you want to do is come in here and you want to adjust this a bit. So right now it says Spacebar Agency. If you happen to see something that says site title and you are on 7.1, I never mentioned this before, but this is mainly for 7.1, and you want to edit that. This is how you do it. So let me just change that back for now. So click edit. Sometimes when you start your site, it doesn't save the site title. So you just have to go into the editor. You could do this on any page of your website. And then at the top, click edit site header. Once you do that, click site title and logo, which you'll see here. And once you click on that, that's where your site title lives. If you're in 7.0, it's a whole different process, but this is where your site title lives. This is where you could upload your logo and your mobile logo as well. But if this just says site title, because you may have a logo here, you might not see it. You might see your logo and it all looks fine and dandy, but it says site title. So you do want to change this to whatever your business name is. So that is saved. From here, you could add other details. So I'm not gonna go into details about how to figure out what the best keyword and keyword phrases are for your business. But if you have a sense of that, that's maybe some information you might want to add in here. So you can see here, I just added a bit of information. Now, with that said, what I would do is I would just literally copy this. And you could adjust it if you want, but I would just paste it in for all three of the different sections. So this is something people overlook at times. I often see that they don't have anything here, or they just might say like their company name, which is cool. And there are recommendations so that this is not too long, but a little bit of info there is good. All right. And then the SEO site description. If someone searches your website and your homepage shows up, this description is what shows up. So this is the description that's down here in the gray text. So we are a place for you. Obviously not long enough, and it's not descriptive. You don't want to say we've been in business for 80 years. You want to say what you do. Act as if you're talking to, respectfully, a caveman. Let them know we sell plants and pots. not we make your home an environment that's beautiful and luxurious and nice. That's cool if you have a lot of traffic and you have a big audience. You could be more artistic or brand oriented in that way. But when you're starting out, you want to be as clear as possible, primarily for Google and secondly for your user. If I go to Google and I type in bookkeeping services or accounting services for freelancers, and the link I go to says some fancy language or says things that are irrelevant, those are not going to connect. So as close as you can be to bookkeeping services for freelancers, if that's what you are targeting, you want to be as clear as possible there. All right, so that is that. Google search keywords, we're going to kind of talk about in a moment. It's going to take you to Google Search Console within the platform. But for now, we are good to go. So that is the SEO panel. Number two, we're going to talk about on-page SEO. Okay, so for number two, we're talking about on-page SEO. What is on-page SEO? So on-page SEO comprises two parts, right? So the first one is the on-page. So we know we have over 300 words on the page. Excellent. We're very clear and descriptive about who we are. The second part is this little gear wheel. Now, there's another video I have about metadata that I'll link below, that you can go and look and find all the metadata in the different sections of your website. So if you click on this gear wheel on the settings page, basically every settings page has this option for SEO that you want to update. Now this is the home page, so let me actually do it on another page story. Click SEO. You'll see here you could add in the SEO title and the SEO description. Now let's take a step back. Remember a moment ago in the SEO panel, we updated that content, Spacebar Agency, for like the line, indoor plants and pots for your home, blah, 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 all that content. Well, now it's added to the title. So you don't have to do it for every single title. You do it once on your site, then it goes to all of your pages, all of your content, all of your collections, all of your items, all of your events, everything on your site, if you do it in the SEO panel and you do it right. I often don't write in an SEO title here, as what it's drawing and what it's pulling here is already perfect. So the SEO description is where I spend time. You'll see here 50 to 300 characters long. You want to make sure you're filling that out for every single page. That is like the first guide for Google to understand what is on your page and then the actual content on your page as well. So you can see that for pages. If I go to the journal, and then I click on settings for one of the posts, you'll see you also have it here. So you can add a description for every single blog post. You could also do this for your store. Okay, so when you are in the store, you can click the three little dots, click edit. It takes you into the editor. So this is the new editor. If you haven't seen this, it's a beautiful layout. I'm thinking about making a video of walking through this editor and how it works. But once you're in here, down here, there's this SEO and URL section. You can click edit. And then in here, change the domain anytime the URL. For all your URLs, you never want something like this. So change that, fix it to something that's more relevant. If this was like a ring, gold, cool. Like that's it. You could change the title. Kind of same principles apply here that we just talked about. But the SEO description is really important to fill out. When you fill that out, you want to include 1 to 2 keywords, keyword phrases. You don't want to do keyword stuffing, so you don't want to just throw 20 keywords there. Everything you do with SEO, it should be readable. If it's not readable, Google sees that, they sense that, and it's not beneficial to your SEO at all. So make it legible, make it something that it was read out loud would make sense. So we'll click apply there, done, get out of that. And this is the same thing for events as well. Anything on your site, you want to make sure you're optimizing for the on-page SEO. From there, let's talk about connecting Google Search Console. There's two ways to do it. Again, I'm not doing a full instruction here. You could go to the Spacebar website and see it. But one thing you definitely want to do is if you go to analytics, you want to come in here and you want to go to search keywords and then connect Google Analytics. Basically, you click here. They're going to ask you to connect it to one of your email accounts, a Gmail account. And you hit yes. And basically what ends up happening here is you've now connected your site to Google Search Console. And so now anytime you update content, it'll automatically update with Google Search Console. I recommend having both connected. What I mean by both, go to googlesearchconsole.com or whatever, just Google it, find the website, add your website there. At the same time, you want to connect it here. The reason is it just makes sure all the data is everywhere. This is the same thing for Google Analytics. I recommend, even if you never use Google Analytics, to connect it to your website, because you connect Google Analytics to your website. You also have the Squarespace Analytics. But now you just have all your bases covered. It's all free, so you just have to set it up and you're good to go. But it's good to let Google know what's happening on your website, giving them a clear sense of how it's working. That's maybe not official language that Google would use, but it's the language that I use. A few other things to think about with SEO is if you go to settings, I would just make sure all this information is filled out. Language and region is correct. If you had a designer build the site and they're in another part of the country, this could be different. So this is correct for me because it pulled up where I'm at. From there, there's also business information. You want to update and have as much of this included as you possibly can. It's not necessarily showing up on the site, but it does show up in the code. So that's important. Social links, add that to your site. You could see there are a few social links here. Domains, this is one thing that we recommend to all our clients. This should never show up on Google, but halibut saxophone should not be your built-in domain. So if you click on this, you could change this to whatever you like. There's no spaces, so just kind of like one word. You hit rename, and it says, are you sure? And you want to do this in the beginning because it just saves in that whole process later on. But you hit confirm and then it changes the built-in domain that you see up here, the halibut saxophone, all of that. So I'm just gonna leave it for now. From there, you obviously wanna add your own custom domain as well to your site. You can go to advanced, click on SSL, turn on HSTS. Basically that ensures that your site shows up with the HTTPS, which is that added layer of security, which is good for your business. Now, again, with all of that covered, we have an online course, we have services, we can do keyword research for you. We have a ton of different services that we offer that can be very beneficial to you. So if you need any help with this, here are some of the services we have. If you need any help with this, if you're transferring your website to Squarespace and you're looking to keep the SEO, we have this 100-point checklist plus the website transfer. We could look up the top 5 keyword phrases for your business, the top 25, or any of our SEO packages. And if you just are looking for a site audit, let us know as well. These are things that we can help with if you are looking for it. But if not, I love the DIYer. I love the person going out and making this happen for their business. So use these things, make sure all that metadata is filled out. It's a lot of information, even if you have a small website, but make sure all that stuff is filled out. And those things will really help with your SEO. It's a long game, but that's a starting point. Make sure you have that journal, the blog, some type of section where you're updating content consistently, even if it's once a month. I recommend more than that, but if it's once a month, it's a good place to start. And again, if you're looking for more content like this, we publish videos on Squarespace SEO constantly, a lot of other videos around the digital world as well. So thank you for watching. I know this was kind of a really quick overview of a lot of different things. Thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell. Thank you for staying connected. If you have any other questions, drop them below. And with that, have a great rest of your day wherever you are in the world, and I'll see you guys next time.